going to do.
So we're starting off with a warlock against a warlock.
Mirror match. Oh wow, we see Morai plays two sea giants. Wow, it's going to be so interesting.
But better have two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's going to be so interesting because you have to be a little bit lucky if you can time the sea giant. Mm-hmm. Maybe they will keep it.
No, not two, just mm-hmm. one.
Okay, so Molai kept the sea giant, and Kabushi also kept the sea giant.
And well, they almost they have two of the same cards here.
Mm-hmm. But you also could choose not to play sea giant and trade everything, you know. So your opponent will not be able to play the sea giant.
No, but it's about minions on the board. So mm-hmm. If your opponent plays a lot of minions to throw his 8/8 the next turn. Then mm-hmm. you can play the sea giant first. That's a cool thing.
That was exactly what I was trying to say. Okay.
Oh, wow. Shifter Cerus. That yeah. would be awesome.
I hate that card.
Awesome.
I had it a few times, also out of the Dark Peddler, and now you see Kabushi here.
Playing Dark Peddler.
Yeah, picks the card he thinks is the best.
Wow, this is going to be very exciting because mm-hmm. You never know what is going to happen. I think he's going to play the Dark Peddler mm-hmm. also.
So many mm-hmm. possibilities. Buying or selling.
And it's Voidwalker again. That's the stupid thing about this.
Put this apple on your head.
And off Juggler is on.
Get it out. It can coin the 8/8.
Okay, he just misses it. It would be a disaster for Molai if
he cannot coin it anymore.
If the Juggler would hit the Voidwalker. Okay, let's see what he's going to do. He also have to keep in mind that, you know, he needs to trade and then play a couple of minions, but not too many of them, in case of the sea giant. Okay, so he can play two minions right here. Yep.
Three is four.
Now, if he plays three minions.
No, but
his opponent can play the sea giants, so he has the ability to play two of them.
No, but he has this so one, runs a 1/1 mm-hmm. together
that's
with it.
Yeah,
so
that's two, and then he's finished. If he plays the Voidwalker with it, he's going to run the sea giant. He can play the sea giant. Yeah, he's going to do it. That's not good. I would play the sea giant here 100%.
Yeah, and then trade a few minions.
Of course. And then your opponent cannot play the sea giant, and then he's in a really, really bad spot. Because you have a lonely sea giant on board.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's going to be really hard to come back from that one. Yep. This is basically... this could be the winning play.
Could be.
Oh boy, that's bad. I would go for... well, maybe it sounds stupid, but you need to play the giant to trade. So I would go for the Forbidden Ritual, but look at the hand of Kabushi here.
I wonder.
This combination. You can then choose for a Juggler into a Forbidden Ritual, but... Wow, this is a really tough spot for Molai.
But then again, you can also play the Dark Iron Dwarf
mm-hmm.
and go for 4 damage.
So many
yep, he's going to play the Forbidden Ritual. This is the correct play in my opinion. But soon he will get the bad news.
And that is that it's a Knife Juggler.
Yep, you can shoot 3 times. Oh man.
Well played.
Yep. That's an awful spot to be in. That was just the perfect answer to everything.
And he has a power overwhelming in hand.
Mm-hmm.
He has 2 cards in his hand, but it's very nice
so
to have it.
Yes. Next turn he can burst like 17 damage. Mm-hmm. But right now, play the giant now. First one to trade. Okay, that's also possible. He saves the coin. Oh no, he doesn't save the coin.
No,
he first needed to play the giant, then coin and draw a card. So, small misplay. Those guys are getting tired. That's for sure.
Five, six, seven, no. The power of warming doesn't help.
It's 15 damage.
It is. Mm-hmm.
Maybe he can come back with that Defender of Argus. That would be really, really good.
No, I think it's safe to draw here.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to play... you probably want to play the... Dream Mana card, and then the Power of Whelming.
Nope, he's not going to tap. Oh, wow, that 1-1 down, that's just awful.
That's just very annoying. He can't get rid of it.
Mm-hmm.
But he can give it his 8/8 taunt.
Yeah, and then again, the big sea giant of Kabush will stay alive.
And he's dead.
My
then.
Shield for Argon.
It's 8.
Needs to find 2 more damage.
There it is.
Yep. Second power. So okay, so keep in mind for players who are watching at home. It's a sea giant who plays the sea giant of first wins the game. Okay.
Well it's true 9 out of 10 times.
Yeah, that really sucks
for and no big game hunters anymore.
For Malay, yeah. Okay, so these players are preparing for the next match. I think they don't take a break, they just continue playing.
I don't think the Big Game Hunter can be played.
No, they don't play Big Game Hunter, it's way too expensive. Okay, let's hop back in.
And there's this Freeze Mage.
Freeze Mage versus the Druid. I've got no clue about this matchup. In the early years of in the previous season, the Druid was a big favorite. But now, well, we have seen some really good plays from Malay.
Mm-hmm. But keep in mind that they know about their about each other's decks.
No, that's not true. Malay hasn't seen the Druid deck of Kabushi yet.
That's true.
So he banned it in the 5th round. And Kabushi didn't know about Malai's Warlock deck, but he has seen it now.
All right.
I hope you like my invention.
Well, let's see what is going to happen. Probably gonna play the ice barrier here.
Yep, it's got the space for it right now.
I think you want to play the Emperor Towerson as a freeze mage when you have a lot of minions in your hand.
Yeah, a lot of cards.
Yeah, well, a lot of cards, sorry.
Yeah, and you want to have, you know, an ice lance with frostbolt or something like that.
That's a good card.
Wow. I would love to see this minion into action.
Mm-hmm.
wow, it's going to be like a 6-4 damage with charge.
Oh yeah. That's true.
And this guy is going to be
a 2-2 slime and
at a mana crystal. Ooh. And what about this? Two mana, 4 damage, draw card.
Wow.
That's really good. Oh, BMing here.
The land serves me.
And the mana crystal. Wow.
And he has the inner fate, picked up the inner fate. So that's gonna be 8 mana next turn.
Does he have lethal next turn? Let's see, it's 4, 8, then 13 plus 10,
what to
23,
do?
No, 25 do. Damage. Wow, that's really sick.
Only 25 damage.
Oh wait, but the Savage Rose, of course, is 3 mana, so you need to wait a couple more turns to build on the board. But this is a really interesting deck. I really like the fact that he doesn't play the cartoon. You see? The decks from the people who were in the finals, none of them was playing Cthun, except Granby.
Right.
Wow, you still can get so much value out of this.
Is it lethal?
No way, where right?
With
Whoa, that looks cool. He's got lethal? No way. We counted it, right?
Well.
But it is a lot of damage.
You sure got some spanking going on. It's his 6th turn and he's on 5. That's a fantastic draw.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he has a double Ralph, so it won't matter.
The end is coming!
This is the only thing he can do.
And can I say that an empty board is also a trouble for him?
For who?
For Molai. Mm. But it's not gonna be an empty board, but if it was an empty board, he could have played his Ragnaros on an empty board in your face.
Yep. Now he only misses the mana, so.
Oh. He has to pick up a ice block.
Yeah, but that will just be like. Nope, there's no way out.
There is no way out. Nope.
He still can survive one turn if he uses the Cone of Cold and ping it. Cone of Cold freezes 4 minions, right? Or 3 minions, and he has to use the Ice Lance then. That's the only thing what he can do.
What to do?
I don't see how that works. Guess it's well.
He can survive a turn.
Yeah, that's true.
Well played. You win this.
Nope. There's the GG.
Well,
wow.
That was a short game for Freeze Mage.
Just like that. That's how you play the Druid these days. So, Kabushi gets the check mark on that, and then suddenly it's 2-0 in the final. So, things are really going different here.
Yeah, and it was a very quick game, and I did like the 3-5 here.
It could be the one of the shortest finals ever.
But don't forget, Molay did win their first match, so he can win. He still can win.
Of course, he can win. So he now knows his opponent only has the Shaman and left, and he knows the deck. So.
And we do have an interesting game here.
Mm-hmm.
We have the Warlock against the Shaman.
Mm-hmm. So Teo is still watching. Kabushi 2-0 ahead.
The light protects me.
Sponsored by AT Gaming.
Why do you call?
Well, but how is he going to win 3 times in a row from the Aggro Shaman? That's really tough to win. Has no 2-drop here.
Did he play the Bronze Spirit here?
Nope.
Feral Spirit is gonna be it.
And look at this deck art.
Yeah.
Maybe you had that idea for me.
Oh, that's. I think that's.
Because I did the same thing in at the Dutch Comic Con.
Put this apple on your head.
Get in there and fight, maggot.
Yeah, this is what he has to do.
Mm-hmm. See, China, it's really good versus the Shaman.
I think you play the Bronze Spirit coin Dark Peddler.
That's a good decision, I guess. No, nope, I'm going for it. Wow, what would you pick here? You don't want to get damaged, right?
No.
And you don't want to pick the chicken.
And you don't have anything.
He's going for the muscles.
Flame him.
Yeah, but because he can't trade it that well.
I think he should have played the Bronze Spirit here.
Yeah, to draw two cards. But he has obviously he has some kind of plan, because he already has, he still has the coin. And I think he wants to combine something with Abusive Sergeant, with the coin, and then on one of his mains, and then blow everything up with Shadow Flame.
Mm-hmm.
But look at the hand here of Kabushi. So many strong minions.
And he plays the Bloodlust, we see.
Mm-hmm.
But we already know knew that, right?
Who knows
yep.
What secrets will uncover?
So, for the people at home and in the chat box, Theo HS is saying, fun fact, Kabushi will be playing Spring Preliminary next week. I know, and he will be facing you, Theo, because you won an Alphen in the Red and I was there.
Back to the game, I think you should play Flame Juggler here. And then the 7-7.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting hot in here.
Whoa, so many muscles in that 7-7. Yep, goes for it. But now he could. He can do the combination. No, he has played the Abusive Sergeant already. But he still can combine to kill everything with the Power Overwhelming and the Shadow Flame. But that's three cards for only two. I don't think he will make that play. I think he's going to play a Giant of his own.
Yeah, and then kill the...
Well, he can go Knife Juggler, play the Giant, see what he juggles and trade into it. I think he has to do something like that.
No, he has to play it safe, I think, with the Sea Giant, and then...
And then you float one mana.
No, you play the...
Wow, he's not going for the Giant. Oh, of course, he has the Brand Bronze Beard.
Yeah.
So he was gambling here to hit the Faceless. Yeah, he needs the luck on this side. The juggle was going face, so it was a bad juggle.
I thought he was going to play Power Overwhelming.
Mm. Now he's really looking for a lot of value, Molay. What will it be? That's really good with Bloodlust.
It is.
That's like 10 points of damage, 17 points of damage. Oh god.
He has to kill it.
And he has the Windlord.
Get it out!
Why, he still saves the coin, man.
Oh, he's gonna play. Oh, he's
scoring into tap. He can do 10 damage, 18, 20, 26. So, if Kobushi doesn't trade, or doesn't kill anything, he's dead.
Yeah, but he has a lightning storm.
He just picked up the lightning storm. Wow.
But he's going for the charge.
He's going for the Windlord. Yep. Going to kill some minions.
Wow.
Second power overwhelming. Does he have enough? No, he's... he's 3 off. Yeah, he can do like 14. No, that's not true. Overwhelming in the on the possessed villager to trade with the Windlord. And then he has 18 left, so he's 7 off.
Or you Shadow Flame both.
Mm-hmm.
And go face with the 8-8. He has not, he doesn't have an answer for the 8-8.
Yeah, that's also a good play. That's also good. Yeah. That's even a better play.
I know.
Yeah, he has to throw in the Shadow Flame right here. He's going to play another giant. Oh. Oh, he knows he's dead when the Bloodlust comes out, right? No, don't do it, please. Go for the Shadow Flame, go for the Shadow Flame. But he still can clear this guy, right?
So yeah, he still can.
No, so he's not dead. Not yet.
Not dead yet.
Wow, this is actually a good play, because he does not need to play the Shadow Flame right now. He's really waiting till the last moment. And look at the hand of Kobushi, because yeah, he can drop two minions, but those will be killed. There's actually nothing Kobushi can do.
No, but I like my play better in this case, because he could have set up lethal.
He still got it. It's at 16 plus 10, it's 26.
Yeah.
So he's still dead if he doesn't do anything.
No, but he's gonna trade it.
And by the way, was that a low roll on the one giant? No, no, no. He got the high roll, so he needs to trade in. Wow, what was he thinking?
That's 16.
Wow, no, he sets up lethal. That's what you want to do, but he's too late. It's 26 points of damage. And
wow.
Malai comes back. And I like... wow, I really like it. I like the fact that he did here.
Yeah.
Okay, so I hope Malai's feeling less pressure right now, because his hands is a little bit shaky.
2-1.
2-1. And he got the check mark on the Warlock.
So is he going to tie up the game? And
I hope so, because he can be a local hero, because he's playing a pro player, and well, we will see. So now it will be Freeze Mage versus the Bloodless Shaman. And actually, I do think this is a good matchup for Malai.
Yeah.
He's shown that he played his Freeze Mage very well. And yeah, he knows his deck very well.
He does.
Let's see what's going to happen. Oh, that's a nice 2-drop.
Yeah, it is.
Mind if I roll knee?
This has to hit face.
That was a mistake.
Wow, Kobushi is really fooling around here.
But he is going to trade this in. Draw a card and just ping the 2-1.
He probably does that, yes. But look at the hand here of Malai. It's really bad.
Well, it's not even necessary to ping it. You can play Ice Barrier. to be more on curve.
Mm-hmm.
But he does make it.
Yeah, but he cannot know. Kabushi has no play. So this only will be like a totemic call, and then his things from low will be cheaper.
Well, I was thinking Cone of Cold, because his flame juggler was...
Cone of Cold?
Yeah.
On one minion, you mean?
No, but if he left it for to one flame juggler and played the ice barrier, then he could have thought, well, I play the Cone of Cold next time.
Mm-hmm. And look at this, this is really interesting, because he plays two totems right here. And he coins the Flame Tongue Totem. But he played it on the other side. So his next totem will be on the other side. So he has two totems equipped with the Flame Tongue Totem. But it's destroyed, and that's already an end of this story. But I like the fact he thought about it. So he has more options left next turn.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, he can fireball it.
He can. But you don't want to play too many spells on on your opponent's...
That's true.
Because that's your kill.
Mm-hmm. Probably he's going to ping the 5-5 and to set up a flame strike. Some nice bluffing here.
It's an ice bear.
Vaporize. Oh wow! So he really can prepare here for the flame strike to ping the other 5-5, and then play the ice block, something like that. But he gets a lot of damage, man. He really gets a lot of damage.
What would you do? Play the Cone of Cold.
Cone of Cold and ping the 5-4 then, because if he goes for ice block and he pings the 5-5, Kabushi is smart enough not to play any more mains, because it's so obvious. Yes, he has a flame strike, so he's just going to play the Totemic Call, and if it's a healing totem, if he's so unlucky, well, you see, and he's going to ping face.
Yeah, because the one damage from the Cone of Cold.
Yeah, but he still can. Yeah, he's helping me with the healing totem. Nope. Oh, he's going to throw in everything. Healing totem. Nope. So, nice board wipe here. Value flame strike. For Malay. But I
can
would.
Be?
To be 100% sure, I would ping the thing from below here.
Why?
Because if you got a healing totem, the thing from below will stay alive.
True.
Yeah.
True.
I wonder.
But maybe he doesn't want it to make it that obvious, you know. And you could also speculate, if he wants to get the healing totem, why not first play the Discord attack? But none of that matters anymore, because Kabushi lost his board. But the good side of the story is, Shaman can build a board quite easily. That's the healing totem he wanted. Okay, what now? No draw cards for Malaya. He would love to see something like Arcane Intellect and or an Amulet of Pain, something like that. Now we're here for some pressure. Why not? This is a really good card.
Yeah.
I think it's the best Shaman legend there is.
Are you gonna Frost Nova and ping?
Nah, he's probably going to trying to remove some stuff. But I don't think he's going to play the Blizzard, because he's not killing really stuff with it. So I suspect he's going for the Blizzard, okay. But I really suspect a ping on the Windlord first, or he's going to combine it with another damage spell. uses his. Okay. Uses his hero power. He also could play the Baltic Stalmers. And then go for the Iceland. So I had a minion on board. And he could draw with it. So that's a decision he made. Because his Baltic Stalmers will be sending him for a long time. I think I would do that. Here again, he can't clear it. He does not want to spend two cards over just one.
Do you play Arcway Centenitis in this freeze match?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he does?
Yes, of course.
I wonder.
Alright.
So, bringing face. Look at the hand. You know,
he has hex.
Bushi is really lucky. He draws minions he can play. And for the rest, he all have spells. But Molai will notice this. He's thinking maybe of, okay, he's going to burst me. Or he has dead cards in his hand. That's a nice card for Molai. He's definitely going to throw this one in. Yep. Oh, wow.
Picking up the torch. Mm-hmm. I think he will go for the Doomsayer Frost Nova and Ping play, but he has a hex in hand, Kabushi.
Yep. If Alexstrasza comes in the next few turns, Molai will win it.
What to do? What to do?
If he freezes the minions now and he tops it, Alexstrasza, he will win the game. Yep, he's exactly 15 damage then. You can use his wrong torch or whatever he wants.
Then you have to do this play.
Yeah, let's go for it.
Time runs out on me.
The end is coming!
Bang to the face. Oh man. Oh man, I really hope he tops like that. Never will
make
it. Come on, the hometown hero needs to have some luck versus the pro.
And that is not a freeze minion anymore.
Oh, what is it? Would he have any 10 cost minions in the deck, you think? I don't think so. Alexstrasza?
No.
Really tough. I think he wants to draw here on Fireball and 4-6.
Yeah. Because you have the torch, right? It's 6 also.
Mm-hmm. So they still can do 15 damage.
But he has to draw a card first.
Yep, and if he did not
invention.
Ping but played the Blood Mage Talents, he would have seen one more card. So
another card, I guess.
I hope you like my invention.
That's no good.
Time runs out on
me. How many damage is that?
Oh, he's already going face. Can he do 20 damage? No way. It's 12. Oh, but the block mage tower. Can he finish it off with the block mage tower? So it's 2, 6 mana, 8. No, it's like 7 plus 7.
It's 14.
We have to learn to count.
No, it's down.
He's got it. Right?
Yeah, 6, 8, no, he's...
No, he has it. 6 plus 6 is 12. 15 plus 4 is 19. Oh no, yeah, he does it. Yeah, yes, because he has the wrong torch.
Yeah, but
he wins because of the wrong torch.
But that's too many mana.
No, it's 6 mana, 9 mana, 10 mana, he's got it.
Ah.
Oh, wow. That's such a good play. That's really well played.
What?
He's not going to miss it, right?
No, what is 12?
6 plus 6 is 12.
Yeah.
Plus 3 is 15. Plus 9, because he's frozen. Plus 9, 5 plus 9 is 19. So we got it. He misses lethal. Am I going crazy? Or am I missing? I'm doing something wrong.
Gonna do it next turn. That 6, 9. That's lethal, right?
Yeah, he misses lethal, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Well yep.
Played.
6-9. Oh, he... Yeah, he miscounted, I guess. Okay, he's got it. But
so
he had...
Yeah,
he had lethal thumbnail,
yeah.
But never mind, he still wins the game. That was... Wow, he gets a check mark on that one.
Wow. But he had... the ice blocker.
Yep. So maybe he just made the display because he wanted to see more cards of his opponent. So he can get a better read.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh! Something wrong here.
Geras versus Grog!
For Doomhammer!
So this is the final match.
The final game, yeah.
And it's going to be a warrior against a shaman.
Okay, in the chat people say he didn't have the mana the last turn.
We are going to see that in the VOD, in the VOD.
Yeah, but no, wrong torch is 3 mana.
Yeah.
Okay, fireball is
4
mana, so that makes 7 mana. And then he had
Frostbolt
2, so that's 9, and Icelands is 10.
Yeah,
so he had the mana. Or was he not in turn 10 yet? That also could be possible.
No, he wasn't in turn 10.
He wasn't in turn 10, okay. So, final game, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, it was lethal. I was right, so... Oh, I'm so good at that. Thank you, Theo. So the final game, and this looks like a quite a decent hand from Kabushi.
Yeah, but he plays the Dragon Warrior, and he has a lot of dragons.
He finally has dragons in his hand.
But now he has no hand.
If Molai is going to win it, it's the biggest comeback we've ever seen so
far.
Yeah,
right. Definitely.
Oh, that's a good one.
But he's not in a good spot here.
It's hard to deal with a Totem Golem, but it takes more than just one Totem Golem to kill a Molai right here.
Did you bring some fish?
What is it? No. Okay, we have to give Kabushi some credit here because he's quite unlucky with his totems from Tezcat Totemic. He didn't have a good totem at once in this game. But come on, Molai defeated Kabushi before. In round 5, and if he can do it again, that would be outstanding.
Did I play this matchup last turn? Last turn?
No, because Molai banned Kabushi's Shaman. No, I'm sorry. He banned the Druid, so this matchup was the exact same match was already played. And Molai won it, so it's possible. He can do the dream, man.
Yeah, he can.
Oh, wow, that massive evolution now.
Glory
perfect.
To
that was
wow. What do you think you are going to do here?
He could slam into Alexstrasza's champion to clear something. But then he floats one mana. He just could draw, and then he can use execute on something. But I think he wants to save the execute for the 7/7. Wow, I absolutely have no idea what he's going to do. Yeah, he's going to trade it probably if he doesn't draw something fantastic. Nope, execute into.
Clear the
3-3. No, I think he goes for the 1 alpha value.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, so... Wow, I'm really getting some Hudson lessons right here. Because his style of mana is really different than the way I do it.
But I do like the position of Kabushi here. don't you kill? Do you bash the one tree?
Yeah, you also could town up.
Yeah, you can armor up and play the
blood
hope.
Yep.
Totem golem?
Yeah. I think he wants to. Oh no, you mean like flinting totem, mm-hmm. and to trade it away for free. Yeah, but I think he wants to have less minions on the board and then play the Blood of the Brave. But I'm not sure if Molly knows if Kabushi is playing the Bloodlust. You know, the plus 3, plus 0 to everything.
Well, he knows.
Oh, he knows it. Okay, yeah. Then
because
he
they played each other.
Yeah, but I believe he hasn't seen it yet. Okay, let's see what he can do right now. He can go for...
Does Molay place the brawl?
No. That's why it was so good he won versus the Patron Warrior. That's really good.
Well,
I wonder.
Do you bash the one tree or the three tree? Do you bash anything, or do you play the both of?
I have no idea.
Going to be hex on a 2/6, kill it with your 1/1, play the totem golem and do a lot of damage phase.
Uh-huh. But you also could go for Master of Evolution, yeah, see, so it's going to be a 6 drop.
Let
will
me
it be?
Change your mind.
Okay, that's not the best 6 drops you could hope for, but
it's
well
good.
Played.
You can't get rid of it.
Wow.
That's
a lot of minions.
That's 8, 10, 13 damage.
You could go for like Azure Drake Bash for 4. Oh. He could bash the totem golem
yes.
Then, but he also could go for double Ravaging Ghoul and then uses his weapon into some of the big guys and he can use his bash the turn after.
Yeah.
But it's so hard to clear this, I mean, come on man.
It's a very
what now?
But, I mean,
tough position
yeah.
to be in here for Molay.
But look at I mean, Kabush, again, the Master of Evolution, he has, he could be a Sylvanas, but he's getting, again, the worst possible minion.
Does he have a dragon?
No, oh, he doesn't have a dragon yet. No more. Okay, is he going to use his axe? No. You know, if Kabush would draw the Bloodlust, he won the game. So he's really close, but he's just unlucky here.
Well, I don't want to say that he is unlucky with this board.
No, but it could be 10 times worse for my life.
Really.
Yeah, but now he's getting the value of the Ravaging Ghoul. Can he top deck a dragon? That would be great. dragon, please? Nope. Okay, but you can draw a lot of cards. You can go like Acolyte, Ravaging Ghoul, Ravaging Ghoul, draw two cards, and then go with this weapon for five, and then he only has a 1-1 left and a hex, and then he is in a very, very good spot. He's going to do it! He's going to make this play.
And an Inner Rage. Feel something?
He's going to make the play. Wow. Oh my gosh, this is a disaster for Kabushi.
Oh,
this is a disaster.
Then Inner Rage?
Yep. Oh, it would be so sad if he draws the Cold Blood of, if he draws the Bloodless right now. His whole board is gone. This really looks good for the amateur player. Another hex! Oh, Lady Luck is not on his side. He has nothing in hand.
I think this is a card roll with a 1-1 here.
Let's go for weapon first. Pure control. What is it? Not bad at all.
It's a 3-2.
It could be, you know, that sucky blade.
And he has to kill the 1-1 totem.
Yep, he's going to draw another card. It's a small misplay here because
he had to draw it first.
Yep. Or pick the weapons first, but not armor first. But nevertheless.
Well, why play Melkrog? I like Melkrog right now.
No, he could
and
play.
The Bloodless.
Oh man, this really sucks for Kabush. No, but you could play Hellscream and then go into the totem so he can do more damage. So two more turns, that's a good weapon.
No, it's lethal, right?
Yeah, is it?
Yeah, with Inner Rage.
Oh, of course! Oh my goodness!
So, wow!
Well, we are facing the biggest comeback in Amsterdam ever!
Wow!
Unbelievable!
I never thought that in the beginning of
the
game.
No, really.
That is very nice.
But we really have to applaud and give some credit to Kabush. He was really unlucky with the totems.